Hello students, welcome back to class of English. I hope you all are revising the poem which we did in our previous video. Now today I am back again with chapter 1 of that same unit 1. The name of the chapter is Wonderful Waste. So are you all ready? Shall we start with our lesson? Okay, can you see this picture and tell me that what is this girl doing? Yes. She is throwing the piece of newspaper into the dustbin. Now see, from that waste newspaper, a basket and a piece of art made of that waste paper. See, are you all able to see from that waste newspaper, a new basket and a piece of art has been made. Now what are these? Are you all able to see? These are waste clothes, waste pieces of clothes. Now from that, see, this doormat and hairband are made of from that waste pieces of clothes. Now can you see this picture and tell me what this picture is showing to you? Throwing waste peels of vegetables and fruits into the dustbin. So yes, today we are going to learn a short story based on waste management and name of lesson is Wonderful Waste. Now see, shall we start with our story? Once the Maharaja of Travancore ordered a grand dinner in his palace. Now we all know Maharaja means king. Of Travancore ordered a grand dinner in his palace. Now see, here is Maharaja of Travancore. Now see, palace of king. This is the palace of king, king of Travancore. Now Travancore is in the state of Kerala. Where is this place located? In the state of Kerala. Now in the afternoon before the dinner, the Maharaja entered the kitchen to survey the dishes that had been prepared for the feast. Now what is the meaning of feast? Feast means you arrange dinner or you arrange lunch at for special occasion for the special guest. Now in the afternoon before the dinner means dinner, you all know that we take dinner at night and at noon we take lunch. So in the afternoon he went to check the dishes, whether all the dishes are being prepared properly or not. Survey, the meaning of survey is to check whether all the dishes are being prepared or not for the feast. Now as soon as he went to the kitchen, he saw that vegetable scraps are being put on the corner. So what are you going to do with these vegetable scraps? He asked the cook, pointing to the basket of scraps near the cook. So he asked the cook that what are you going to do with this vegetable scraps? The cook replied, they are waste. We will throw them away. So at that time when the king asked the cook, the cook replied that they are waste. We will throw them away. That is of no use. The scraps are of no use. Can you see in this picture? These are the scraps of vegetables and fruits. Cook said that he will throw that. Now you cannot waste all these bits and pieces of vegetables. Find a way to use them. The Maharaja commanded sternly and walked away. Now as soon as cook told that he will be throwing that scraps, then at that time the Maharaja ordered that you have to make use of these vegetable scraps. You cannot throw all these vegetable scraps. Sternly means when somebody ordered you that you have to do that work. So same like that, king also ordered to the cook that you have to use this vegetable scrap instead of throwing them. The cook was in a fix and kept staring at the vegetable scraps for some time. Now when the king ordered him that you have to use the scraps, at that time he just started looking at that vegetables. Keep in a fix means he started looking. Means stare means kisi ko ghoor ke dekhna. Staring at that vegetable scraps for the some time. Yani for some times he was just thinking that what to do with this vegetable scraps. Suddenly an idea flashed across his mind. Now we say na, yes, I got it. Same like that, suddenly an idea came to his mind. That's why idea flashed across his mind. So he thinked about some idea and idea came to his mind that what to do this with this vegetable scraps. He took all the vegetable bits, washed them and cleaned them well. Now you all know that before using the vegetables, we used to wash them. Same like that, the cook also washed all the vegetable bits, washed them and cleaned them well. Then he cut them into a long strips. Are you all able to see how these vegetables are being cut into long strips? Then he put them into a huge pot and placed it on the fire to cook. Then see, are you all able to see the pot in which he put all the vegetables, vegetable scraps, and he put it on the fire to cook. Now next he ground some fresh coconut, green chilies and garlic together. All these things he added to the vegetable scraps in a pot. He added this paste and some salt to the cooking vegetables. Now see, all these are the ingredients: coconut, garlic paste, all these are the salt also. All these things he added to that vegetable scraps in a pot. A tempting smell started coming from the pot. As soon as all the vegetables were cooked with these spices, a tempting smell started coming from that pot. Now he whipped some curd and added it to curry. He also poured a few spoonfuls of coconut oil and decorated the dish with curry leaves. After adding all the spices, now he added some coconut oil and curd to that curry which he had prepared in that pot, and he added a curry leaves to decorate that dish. Now lo and behold means when you are able to do something, and when you are able to do that, at that time you are surprised that yet I have done it. Same thing like that. Lo and behold, you are surprised to see that yes, I have prepared something. The new dish was ready. The cook served this new dish to the guest that evening. Now he served that dish to the guest at that evening. Now everyone was eager to know the name of the new dish. The cook thought and thought. Then a name came to his mind. Now everyone was eager to know that what was the name of this dish which the cook has prepared that evening. The cook also started thinking and thinking. Then a name came to his mind. What name he got in his mind? He named it Aviel. That new dish which he prepared from that vegetable scrap, he named it Aviel. Now Aviel today at present become a famous all over Kerala and is now one of the dish in a traditional Kerala feast. And imagine, it all came from a basket of waste. Now how did he prepare this dish? From the vegetable scrap which were waste, which were being not used also, peas and bits which were left over from the fruits and vegetables. But this dish become famous all over the Kerala and it is added to the traditional Kerala feast. These are the leftover peels. No, when you sharpen the pencil, and these are the peels which are left over from the pencils. From that also, see how beautiful pictures and all this painting has been made from that. So these things also show you that you can make best out of waste. Instead of throwing that, you can make best out of waste. Now see, your ice cream sticks has been used. See, are you all able to see? Ice cream sticks are being used, and from that also we can say that instead of throwing that, from that waste, best has been made. So these all are the examples for showing you that how can you make best from all this waste. Now what do you learn from this story? That you should reuse, reduce and recycle the things. Instead of throwing that, you should reuse, reduce and recycle the things. So students, in the same unit we have one more short tale taken from Senthil Folk Tales. So shall we start with our that short folk tale whose name is Bamboo Curry. Now have you ever eaten a dish made from bamboo? Let's read this picture story and find out which part of bamboo can be cooked and eaten. Now one day, the mother-in-law of a Senthil bridegroom cooked a special dish for him when he visited her. Can you see in this picture, mother-in-law cooking a special dish for Senthil bridegroom? So This curry is delicious. What is it? The mother-in-law pointed at the bamboo door. So Senthal bridegroom is asking his mother-in-law that this curry is very delicious. What is it made up of? So mother-in-law is pointing at the bamboo door. Next morning, just as he was about to leave, he remembered that there was no bamboo in his village. Now next morning, when Senthal bridegroom was leaving, so what does it in mind came that there is no bamboo in his village. So he removed bamboo door and carrying it with him left for his home. So at that time what he did, he just removed the bamboo door of his mother-in-law and carried that bamboo door with him in his own village. Now on reaching the village, he told his wife that make curry with this bamboo door. So his wife was shocked and surprised that how can I make curry out of bamboo door. So come, I will help you. Chopping up the bamboo, he said. So now that Senthal bridegroom told her wife that I will help you in chopping this bamboo door and you have to make curry from this. So his wife boiled it and boiled it later with her husband. Tasted. He said that it is too hard to eat. You don't know how to cook. So now Senthal bridegroom is telling to his wife that you have not cooked it properly. It is too hard. I cannot eat it. His wife added more and more water and boiled it again and again. It is still too hard. I cannot eat it. Then that same evening, the in-laws came to visit the young couple that evening. They all laughed at the foolishness of that Senthal bridegroom. Why? Because he took that bamboo door from his mother-in-law house and he told her wife to cook that. The mother-in-law said, didn't you know that curry was made from bamboo shoot and not from the bamboo door? Now at that time, all are laughing at her, at his foolishness, that the curry was not made from that bamboo door. It was made from bamboo shoot. So this was a short tale taken from a Senthal folk tale. See, here you can see, this is bamboo shoot. From this is used as a vegetable also. This root is used as a vegetable. Curry is made from that and not from that bamboo door. So are you all able to understand, students? Okay, thank you. Now we completed with all two chapters and one poem of this unit. I hope you all understand all two chapters and this one poem which we did in this unit. We'll be meeting with the next unit.